Hello. I've been receiving a lot of requests of late for a video on what kind of camera gear to take on a trek. So here it is. I'm going to be picking my gear from here for my trek. First thing I want to tell you is plan your photography out. Decide whether you want to do landscape photography or action shots or portrait photography or maybe wildlife, and only then pick your gear. I can tell you straight away that most of it is going to be landscape photography and perhaps a few action shots. So I'm going to pick my gear accordingly. Now I have a Canon 1100D here. I have a Canon 60D. And I have a Nikon D80. So I'm going to be picking a Canon 1100D. Why? Because this is the lightest of the three cameras. So I need to keep my backpack extremely light because I'll be carrying it myself. My camera gear cannot weigh more than 1.5 or 2 kilos max. So this is the lightest camera body, so I'm going to be picking this. And the lenses are next. So I have an 18-55 lens here. This is the basic lens that comes with the camera. It's good for landscape photography. I've shot quite a bit with it. It does a good job. Outside of this, I'm going to be taking a 50mm for portrait photography. This is very light and you get excellent portrait shots with this. So that's what I'm going to pick. Now, only if you're really into wildlife photography or if you really want to zoom into the peaks that you can see from the summit and click pictures of those, only then take zoom lenses, because zoom lenses are very heavy. For instance, I have a 7200 here. It is very heavy, so I'm not going to be taking it on the trek. On the other hand, I have a 24-105 here. This is also fairly good zoom lens and it is lighter. So even in zoom lenses, you have options. So weigh your options out and then choose your lenses. So your lighter options would be something like a 7300 or a 55-250. So literally weigh it out and then pick. Okay. So after your lenses comes your tripod. Now, only if you're really professional or if you're very serious about your photography, then take a tripod, because tripods are an added weight, and when you pick your tripod, make sure it's light. Here's an aluminium tripod. It's very light. It's around 700 grams, I guess. So this should do. If you want to invest in one, you can take a carbon fiber tripod. That's also very light. So if you don't want to carry something as big as this, you can take a gorilla pod. As you can see, it's extremely tiny and it latches onto pretty much anything. So you can put your camera onto this, maybe put it on the branch of a tree and shoot. So you can take that. Outside of that, you will need spare batteries. So you will need at least one spare battery, because there are no charging points on most treks. 95% of the treks do not have charging points. So take at least one spare battery. If you use your battery judiciously, you can click around 300 to 350 shots with one. So take one spare battery at least. And outside of that, you need a spare memory card. Actually, if you're taking a 16GB memory card, you can shoot enough pictures. Even in RAW, you can shoot enough. But if you're not confident of that, or if you're shooting videos or something, you can take another 16GB. That should suffice. So that covers your camera, lenses, tripods and accessories. If you're taking an adventure camera, then excellent. You can make sure that you take the waterproof case along with it. And even for that, you will need spare batteries. Okay. The advantage is that you can charge these batteries on a power bank. So you don't need to take too many spare batteries. So that pretty much covers everything. You make sure that your gear is light and plan your photography out well in advance. You can read about your trek. If you're going on the Dioriatal, Goichala or Sandakfu trek, there are lots of birds. So those are places where you might want to do bird photography. If you're going on, again, the Dioriatal trek, the views of the mountains there are excellent. So see what your trek is like beforehand and then decide what kind of photography you can do over there. Okay. In my next video, I'll show you how to pack all this into your backpack so that it's all compact and nice. So stay tuned and don't forget to hit subscribe.